You know what surprised me the most about this trailer? The color palette. I was not expecting amber waves of gold, right? He loves gold, that Thanos. Especially after they released that poster yesterday, which was all kinds of cosmic rainbow. Although I also thought, though, on the flip side, that rainbow was also a weird choice for a movie where a bunch of Avengers are supposed to die or be revealed to be Skrulls. I have a theory on that already. I am very excited about this. We're going to dive into it in just a moment with my shot-by-shot breakdown. But the other thing that I thought was interesting is that I think this, you know, some people said they were a little underwhelmed and the trailer didn't go for shock and awe. You know, I think it really, I think it was a hardcore pitch to hardcore fans. And on that note, I wonder, and this reminds me a little bit of the Justice League trailers, if you don't really follow this stuff as closely as some of us do, would you know what this movie was about? Right? I think it really takes a lot for granted as to how closely people are following the storyline, especially because in the movies, they have not done much to set up Thanos. So I wonder how this would play, you know, to the casual moviegoer, right? I think they could have done a little bit of a better job setting up what was happening here. Although, you know, all the Avengers, it's another Avengers movie and they're fighting another big bad. All right, so let's break it down. So we're going to start out with gold right away. And I like the way that you can see the lightning, you know, in the clouds. Like, stuff's happening already, right? A storm is brewing, literally. Love it. Although the Russo brothers, come to think of it, have always been very devoid of color in their films. So gold is actually a huge step for them. Now here's Tony, once again, feeling all remorseful. I thought he might be holding someone's hand, you know, because, you know, like I was like, is that... Steve Rogers' dead bloody hand, but I think it's just one of Tony's hands. He's got one really dirty hand. I guess his armor flew off in that spot. Maybe he's nursing it. But, you know, at some point, Tony's going to have to stop feeling so sorry for himself, right? There's a lot of crying in this trailer, actually. We have a couple other spots. But I'd be like, snap out of it, Tony! He's like, no, there's clearly no... Thanos is really anti-joke. I don't know what to do. I thought it was funny that Marvel kind of took some shots at their own formula. We'll talk about that. So some people have mentioned that, you know, in the original story, which I could not get through, by the way, I was like, oh, I should read Infinity War, kind of important. And I was like, nope, can't do it. Super boring. I'm not a fan of that era of comics. And I was really hard to follow, quite frankly. But apparently Silver Surfer crashes into the Doctor Strange sanctum. And so since there's no Silver Surfer's over with Fox, they've decided, you know, typical Marvel fashion, just give it to another character. They said they have 60 to cover in this movie. And so they gave it to Hulk, who I guess crashes in from space. I don't know where he keeps getting clothes. I was glad to see Wong showing up here and also using some magic, by the way. Now let's go to 50 Shades of Vision. I love it. There's a bed there. They're totally coupling it up. Although, you know what's hilarious? So they're together and... she's like, ah, so sexy. And he's like, yes, look at the light. Look at the light. I was thinking, like, I wish someone, it would be hilarious if someone came in and said, Vision, someone forgot to tell Vision to stop, you know, to turn off his directive to keep Wanda from going outside, right? He's like, damn it, the food didn't work. How about sex? And she's like, bingo, that's going to do it. And I wonder what his decision is to look more human. Maybe that's a hole in his head, right? I don't know. We'll see. Maybe that's, you know, when they pull out the Mind Stone. By the way, some people have talked about the fact that they have a casting call out for twins. You know, it could be their children that she conjures up, right? A little Scarlet Witch and a little Quicksilver, basically. But on the other hand, you have to remember that when children are in films, they usually like to have twins. So they can, you know, but not maybe not for this age range, though. But sometimes they, you know, that's usually for babies, come to think of it. But I don't know. I don't know why they would give that away. I guess they had to have the casting call. But there's going to be a lot going on in this movie, including baby making, apparently, or baby conjuring. So there's Thor with his back to us, because as you'll see at the end, they're like, he does have his eye patch. Thank goodness. You know, you can't just have someone lose an eye and get an eye patch. And then in the next movie, it's like, oh, I'm all better. It's got to last at least for one freaking movie. I think that he seems to be on the Guardians ship there, as you can see that no one's cleaned the windows. Classic Guardians. He's like, this. I hope that's dirt. We know that Peter Quill does a lot of stuff on that ship, as you might recall. So here is Bruce Banner. Looks to me like in Wakanda with part of Tony's Hulk. You know, ironically, he's like, yeah, this armor's useless against me. You know, the Hulkbuster armor behind him. And I was, you know, in the Vanity Fair coverage, you know, they tried really hard to give us some scoops. I don't think it really worked out that well. But one thing that they did say was they were like, hey, Mark Ruffalo, if you could do anything for the story arc in a standalone movie for Bruce Banner, what would it be? And he's like, oh, here's what I came up with. And they're like, great, we're going to spread it out over three movies, starting out with Thor Ragnarok and then the two Avengers movies. So you have a character arc in that way. Because Universal still has first dibs on a solo Hulk movie. And I think that, I don't know, I'm not really feeling the character arc in Thor Ragnarok. I mean, I love that movie. And I thought Bruce Banner had some great moments in it, and, you know, as both Bruce and the Hulk, but I thought he was really shortchanged, especially considering they stole his storyline. He's like, I'd love to do Planet Hulk, when they called him into the meeting, and they're like, sorry, we gave that to Thor. What else would you like to do? He's like, I don't really think Hulk has any good storylines. Maybe he'll disappear into the Hulk forever. That would be kind of interesting. That would be kind of a death in a way, too, right? And they're like, digital Mark Ruffalo is already in the computer, so less of a money for us having to pay you. I don't know where he keeps getting these clothes every time he lands naked. So here's Black Widow. I decided I don't like blonde Black Widow. At first I was like, oh, cool change, and maybe she's hiding out, right? But I just don't like it. There's something about it. I mean, maybe I'll change my mind when I see it more in action and in the movie itself. But I just feel like Scarlett Johansson was like, I like myself better as a blonde. I don't want to be a redhead anymore. It's not working out for me. And so I insist. It seems more like a star or an actor request than what fits the story. She just doesn't seem like the same character. I would much rather, instead of seeing her, you know how I feel about hair. Instead of seeing her have a hair change, I would much rather see her doing some really cool stuff, right? Instead of just using another spear like she did in the first Avengers movie. We'll get to that. So they're all like, we formed this team to do cool stuff that nobody else ever could. And then they slowed down this opening. And as you might recall from my live reaction, I was like, don't waste valuable time with this. It's literally in front of every Marvel movie. I have seen it. All right, so there they are. Again, Bruce Banner got some clothing. Maybe Tony showed up with it. Well, I have something to say about Tony's jacket, too. But you can see Tony has some tech on his hand again. And so Thanos is talking, and he's like, soon you will know what it's like to lose. I like Thanos' lines, by the way. And then there's the spider sense. But I like Thanos' lines. He's like, even though you feel with every fiber of your being, I'm paraphrasing, that you're right, you will still lose. And I was like, that's pretty poetic, Thanos. It's like there's a little Thanos, like a monologue writer behind him being like, okay, quick, you know, his little Thanos speechwriter. That would be great. Or is this just all off the cuff, Thanos? That's the most impressive thing you've done. So I love the spider sense. We didn't really get a good feeling of that in the Spider-Man Homecoming movie. I love Tom Holland. I think he's such a fabulous Peter Parker in Spider-Man. I'm so excited for him. I'm so glad he's in this movie. He makes one of the strongest impressions. And he's one of the newest people in the MCU, so that's very impressive. Maybe the new guard can take over. I'm still not convinced. They're like, oh, we're going to pass the baton to a new group of Avengers. And I'm like, I'm not feeling it quite yet, but maybe I will after this movie. So he's like, the spider sense is like, look over your shoulder. And so there's like some kind of jump gate. Anyone who reads science fiction knows what that is. It seems to be sucking in typical jump gate fashion. You know, jump gates go two ways, right? In or out. And this seems to be going in. It's gonna like, it's sucking stuff in, and there's like some fires that have already broken out. Looks very Ultron-y in its tech, quite frankly. So here they are. I love it. Whose clothes are those that Bruce Banner's wearing? They look way too big. And I love the faces that Mark Ruffalo always makes. And I have to say, I feel like the sorcerers seem a little underpowered in the face of this. But I think, I don't know what jacket Tony's wearing. I think he's gone from like being really cool to like having a midlife crisis. I'm like, what teenager did you pick that off, Tony? It looks ridiculous. It doesn't even fit. He's like, I totally bought it at the mall at Hot Topic. Leave me alone. I'm having a problem. Nobody likes me anymore. Everyone likes Steve. So when the light comes on, you can see a little bit of this person's costume, and you can see their shoe. And I looked it up, and it's Ebony Maw, right? I did my detective work, and I matched the costume to the character. And that's one of Thanos' Black Order, one of his goons. And you don't see too much of them because they're all CGI-y, okay? But not his feet, so you can see that here in the shot. I'm not quite sure who's dead here. I'm not sure if it's people on Earth. It might be something to do with the Nova Corps, because you're going to see momentarily that he has that Infinity Stone. So Ebony Maw's going through. Ebony Maw is not one of the big muscles. He's more the brains of the Black Order, so it would make sense that he wouldn't be on the front line. So this is fascinating to me. So I think Loki might be crossing a line here, finally. And I'm not sure how I feel about it. So he's crying. So, and he has the Tesseract, which we all knew that he took at the end of Thor Ragnarok, right? And he seems to be offering it up. And I'm not sure if he's crying because he's trying to save someone or because he's like, he knows he's crossing a line. He's like, I'm going to save myself. And my, I don't think Thor's really not going to forgive me on this one. And then I also think that he seems to be using it to bring Thanos in. That seems like Tesseract travel to me, Space Stone. And I don't know why he wouldn't use the jump gate. So I'm not quite sure. But Loki seems to be involved. So Loki. I want him to be better, but that's really bad. So, okay, speaking of bad, here's Thanos. I think his eyes are too small. Also, he looks so much like Josh Brolin that I'm like, why didn't you just put Josh Brolin in makeup then? If he's going to look that much like Josh Brolin, just put him in makeup and on some stilts and build out the rest of him, right? But keep his head to some degree. It looks so much like Brolin. And his eyes are very small, and so I think, you know, eyes are windows to the soul and all that, and so it keeps you really from connecting too much to the character. And he doesn't look that alien to me. I'm always, also, speaking of being torn, I'm always torn as to whether or not I think all aliens should be humanoid so that we can, like, kind of know where to look when they're talking, or if they should look more alien-y. And I don't know, this just... Thanos still isn't working for me. And I don't love his suit either. I mean, if he doesn't need the armor, just go shirtless, man. Go all the way. Someone said he looked like Bruce Willis. One of you said he looked like Bruce Willis. That's pretty funny. But Bruce Willis is really goofy. Now, I love this spider suit. Although I have to say, the Good Morning America showed like a little quick clip on Twitter. And I was like, look away! And I thought it was Iron Man. This shot. I thought it was Iron Man because he looks so much like Iron Man. Of course, Iron Man designed that suit. And Tony's like, everything relates to me. But it's beautiful. It's really, really a beautiful suit. And I'm curious as to how he gets it for this sequence. You know, at what point in the movie does he go and say, okay, I'll take that now. And I love the light up eyes. It's so great. It's really cool. They recently had that in the comic. It's a mix of like the Iron Spider suit from Civil War, but also the most recent Parker Industries tech suit. It's beautiful. It's really nice. Although it ages him up a little bit. Okay. I can't wait to see what bonus toys this one has. Although the other one was pretty tricked out. Now here's Pirate Thor. Everyone's calling him Pirate Thor. I think he's Odin Thor. I don't know. I don't know how I feel about the eye patch. I thought it was maybe one change too many. I don't know what he's doing. He seems to be, you know, helping the Guardians to some degree. You know, he's like, you know, after Steve stopped that helicopter, now I'm going to do the exact same shot in another movie, right? And show my muscles off. Now this is great. This is much cooler. So that is Proxima Midnight, the female member of the Black Order, and she's actually married to Corius Glaive. So they're usually seen together. But this gets even more interesting, right? So she throws her spear, right? And someone, a mysterious figure, catches it! Oh! And I was like, who is it? Now you see the brick wall behind him? That's Captain America, you'll see in just a moment. So I love this line, this was a great line, when T'Challa was like, get this man a shield. You're like, oh, you got extra shields around here? Can I have one too? Well, what's going to be on it, by the way? We'll talk about the fact that Steve has removed all the markings, the America markings, from his uniform. He's pretty upset. He broke up with America, and it didn't go well. So here he comes. Here's Captain America. And that's the same wall behind him that just stopped the spear. So it's like, I wonder if Captain America... You know, he turned evil recently in the comics. He turned into a Nazi, which was pretty bad. But maybe he's going to be revealed to be... a Skrull. Oh, what was in the ice? Is this why he's so Bucky obsessed, right? Maybe he and Bucky are both Skrulls, and that's why he has this ridiculous commitment to him. They're like, we're the only Skrulls we know, man. We gotta stick together. I'm not sure. It's fascinating. And so, you know, I don't know, for instance, is Wanda worried about Proxima Midnight, or is she worried about Steve? We'll see. But she did smile a little bit at the end there. Maybe she's like, I'm partially evil too. All right, so there's where we are at Wakanda, gorgeous city. There, more spear action from Black Widow. She's like, I stab all the time. And I get, see, there's Doctor Strange realizing. He's like, yep, I don't have enough juice. This seems like invasion to me. So there they are fighting, you know, typical alien hordes, right? Oh, they got multiple arms, okay. I don't know, that looks medium. And I don't know what, you know, this, I don't know what this cat could do against that thing, right? The Avengers, to some degree, seem a little underpowered, I gotta say. So this is great. We've seen shots like this all the time in the comics. I like it. Light up eyes. Now you see here, Tony's crying a little bit. Is he hovering over a dead Avenger? Is it Spider-Man? I don't know. Well, I mean, I'm seriously injured. You know, being like, because, you know, he brought Spider-Man in. He has culpability there. Now here, this is, that's Proxima Midnight. That's her spear on the left. And this is Corius Glaive on the right with his own weapon. And as we've heard from the set reports, they're pulling out that stone. It's got to go. Hold still. This is going to hurt. And there you see, there's the Tesseract that Loki just offered up. We don't know the circumstances. And it's interesting. Look how tiny those stones are. Thanos is that big? I don't know. I thought the stones were a little bit bigger than that. And when he's next to Iron Man, he doesn't look that much bigger than him. So I'm not sure what's going on here. But I like how they like are magnetically pulled into the Infinity Gauntlet. Ah, that's very cool. Now, this is a crazy line. He's like, I'm not much for fun when bringing together or destroying the universe, but this does bring a smile to my face. And I was like, oh, is that a shot at Tony? And like, there's like really no smile. And you see here, Tony puts his hand up, I guess for a quip maybe? And then Thanos, oh, he is kind of big. And Thanos, yeah, he is very big actually. Oh, he's very big. That's crazy. But he doesn't seem to be that much wider. He's just like super, he's all in the legs. And so he just like, bam, shuts him up. Why doesn't Tony ever get any respect? I just feel so bad for him. At some point, Robert Downey Jr. should be like, do people at the MCU actually not like me? I thought everybody was enjoying my on-set banter. It's like everyone secretly hates you. And that's the back of his suit's got a lot going on there. I was like, that's some crazy design going on. I'm not quite sure. I think it might be a little over-designed. I don't know what a gun's going to do here. Or those claws. I'd be like, you've got to have more weapons here on Wakanda, man. I don't really think that we might be a little underpowered. You know, it's a little like the Amazons in Justice League. You're like, seriously? You think this is going to work? Now this, you know, interestingly, you can see there's the Hulkbuster armor. And so Tony's part of this fight, too. This might be like the airport battle. Although they seem to be just fighting a mass of, you know, aliens. I like the fire in the trees. That's very cool. That's a little Apocalypse Now-like. I wish they would actually go Apocalypse Now. That would be even cooler. Now, there's that amazing shot. Look at the waist. I mean, poor Black Widow. She just can't compete with Steve's hair. She's like, ah, his hair's so beautiful. Damn it. Like, just the way it moves. Although you saw in another shot, it really gets in his eyes, right? Like, where's my headband in my pocket? Also, you can see he has some Wakanda like gauntlets on. I'll be curious to see if that's at all helpful. And he did black out the front of his suit. He's like, no America for me. And he and Widow and Bucky all seem to be dressing alike. And then you've got, again, War Machine, Falcon. Very, very interesting. And a Hulk, of course. And then they're like, Avengers Infinity War. And again, it's gold, not rainbow. So what's with that poster? Why doesn't the poster match anything in the trailer? And then you have this great little stinger at the end. I think this is great. So he's like, who are you guys? And I love this shot. First, I love the look on Chris Pratt's face. I think he's like, I want my act back, bitch. You know, because I think that to a very large degree, Chris Hemsworth borrowed substantially from Chris Pratt, right? I'm very curious to see how a scene between the two of them plays, because they're doing the exact same thing. But I have come to like the Guardians much more after the second film, and they look very cool here. And this is the rainbow color palette that I was hoping for. Wow, Drax really blends into the background there. I didn't even notice him when I was watching the trailer. His eyes look very cool. His eyes look really neat. This is the rainbow color palette that we've been seeing. I like Mantis's wave. She's adorable. I really like that character. But I also really like, by the way, Teenage Groot. Teenage Groot is fabulous. I can't wait for to see how he acts in the movie. It's so great. And then they're like, May 2018. All other movies, so long. So I think it's a fun trailer. I think it's very exciting. But I do think it's a little inaccessible. And I think they should have done a little bit more to set up the story. Because I just don't know why they won't set up Thanos. They're like, we don't need to talk about Thanos. And you're like, you do. You really do. They're like, 10 years of the MCU. And I'm like, 10 years of not really talking about Thanos. I don't know why they keep pushing this narrative they've been building to him the whole time. I'm like, you haven't really. You've been promising him the whole time. And so I think they have a lot of work to do in that department. And clearly a lot of CGI-ing to do. You should see the Black Order soon enough. I think they're going to be really cool. So what do you think? Do you think that Steve is evil? I mean, do you think he's going to die, or do you think he's going to be revealed to be a Skrull? That would make my day. I'd be so freaking happy if he was a Skrull. I would love it. Oh, by the way, I think his beard is hilarious. They're like, how can we make him more manly? I know, full beard. It's fabulous. So what did you think? What do you think of the color palette? What do you think? What do you think of the trailer? And what do you think of Thanos? Write your thoughts down below, and you can check out some more episodes right now.